Because of Hurricane Harvey, because of our time constraint, in chapter 2, I'll first cover just this circular flow diagram. So this is called the circular flow model. So this simple model shows you how the market works. We have two major markets, the product market and the resource market. Let's first take a look at the product market. We're kind of familiar with this, right? Just think about HEB. I go to HEB to buy milk and eggs. So that's goods. That's product market. And product market is a place where businesses sell and households buy. You buy your milk, you buy your eggs, and you also buy services, right? Like car services or haircut, these are services, or dry clean service. These are the product market where businesses sell and households buy. So we can see goods and services flow from businesses through the product market to the households. Circles and services, that's how they flow. And in return, of course, households will have to pay, right? So that's consumption expenditure. And the money flows this way, and it becomes the revenue of businesses. That's the product market. Moving on to resource market. So if you remember, what are the resources? From chapter 1, land, labor, capital, yes, and entrepreneur, yes. So just think about labor. Labor is probably more intuitive for us to think of. Households, we will sell our labor in the resource market to the businesses, right? This is hire us. So for example, if you work as a teller at the bank, then you're selling your labor there. And you sell your labor to businesses. And in return, they will have to pay you wages, like salary wages, right? And we know the resources, not just labor, but a lot of them, land, labor, capital, entrepreneur ability. And households will sell this through resource market to businesses. And in return, we're getting rent, wages, interest, and profit, okay? So in chapter 2, we will come back to talk about different market systems like the laissez-faire capitalism and the command system. We'll talk about that later, but we need to first know what market efficiency is. So most likely after we talk about chapters 3 and 4, we'll come back to compare the different systems. But right now, you just need to know this. Okay? Questions so far about the circular flow diagram? If not, I'm going to move on to chapter 3. As I mentioned, I will follow the slides, but because I'm videotaping my lecture, so I'm not going to use a projector. So if you have your computer with you, or you have your slides in copy with you, you can take a look. We're going to move on to talk about chapter 3. Chapter 3 is demand, supply, and market equilibrium. We're going to learn how the market works. So what is a market? A market really is just a group of buyers and sellers. And they interact to discover the price. That's it, very simple. A group of buyers and sellers. So now we're talking about chapter 3.